Hey, it's Colin Smith here from photoshopCAFE.com. Today I want to show you a brand new feature inside of Adobe Firefly image generation, which helps it to generate images based on reference. It's called structural reference. Let's have a look at how it works. So go to firefly.adobe.com, sign in, and then we're going to go down to text to image, and then we're going to hit generate. So what we're going to do is let's grab this, and why don't we do woman taking selfie with phone. Okay, so based on this, we've got four different photos, but what if I want it against an isolated background and I have more of an idea of what I want? Well, I can upload a structure reference. Watch this. We choose upload image. We're going to grab this picture of a selfie here. And now we're going to use this to help us create the same pose with an isolated background. So let's choose generate. And if we look here, now it's generating images in the same pose. Now we can increase the strength, which will make it closer to the original. Let's hit generate. If you notice, they're now holding flowers as well, so they're now much closer to the original image. Now notice it's not taking the color or the style, it's just taking the structure or basically the outline. So if we want this on an isolated background, we could also type in and let's hit generate again. And here we now have an isolated background. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. And notice it's getting much closer to what our original photo is. Now, if I take the strength all the way down, it's going to give it more lenience to kind of generate something that's not so close to the original reference image. And as you can see here, there's a little bit more variance now. And by the way, this is using the Firefly Image 2 model, which is doing a lot better on humans than it did before. Notice we have five fingers and faces that look like real faces now. So let's try a different approach with this, and let's see if we can create some concept art of a spaceship. Okay, so we're going to tell them we want photorealistic concept art. We're going to get rid of the reference. We want to make sure we're doing a photo type. And so we're just basically starting with a new prompt. Let's do this now. All right, we got some pretty cool looking spaceships here, actually. This is really cool. All right, so I want to make it resemble something like, say, a type of insect or something like that. So why don't we have a look at using a reference image? Now, I've shown you can upload your own, but you can also browse the gallery of what's here. So we can see there's different reference images in here already. So why don't we do something like this bird, and let's see if we can create something that looks, it's going to be influenced a little bit by a bird. So there's a structure reference showing here, hit generate. And if you look, these are now starting to resemble the bird. Okay, let's create something completely different. Let's hit clear. And this time we're going to do a castle. And then choose generate. All right, we've got some pretty cool looking castles here. So what if I've got something in mind? I'm gonna upload one of my own sketches. So I'm gonna upload a sketch of a castle. And so this can tell it, hey, you know what? This is the angle I want and the kind of scale. And then we can hit generate. And now it should produce something that looks closer to my illustration, which we can use to help guide it. And you can see now these are much more resembling the sketch that I created. Let's go full strength and see what we get. And if you compare these, this is quite remarkable, really. It's even duplicating the towers and everything that I put on my sketch. So why don't we try something even more interesting? Let's clear this out and let's go a little more fantasy with this. Let's do a steel robot with electric arms. All right, this is a cool robot, but we want a full body. So why don't we do, we could type in full body or we could just go to a sketch that I've created. So let's go ahead and upload a sketch, upload image, and here is a robot sketch. So we're uploading this now. Let's generate again with the structure. Okay, so we're getting kind of an illustrative style here. So these are definitely kind of matching the robot design that I put in. So why don't we change this though? We want to go for more of a photo. And we're going to hit generate again. I'm going to drop the strength down a little bit to about the middle because I feel like it's trying too hard to copy the illustration and it's not giving it enough room for things like the head. And then we look at images like this. If we want to download them, just click the download and that will download them. Okay, let's try modifying the prompt a little bit, and then we're going to hit generate one more time. Yeah, this is getting closer. Maybe just change this to menacing. So this is how we're using the new structure reference inside of Firefly. So this is going to make it easier to mix AI with photographs and our own art, like creating more predictable results so we can use them for things for like composites, for creating elements and different things like that. Remember, the structure reference guides the shape of the object, the size and positioning. If we want to do things like style, we can upload a different reference for the style. So this is a newer feature inside of Adobe Firefly. I'd love to know you guys' comments. Let me know underneath. And if you're new to the cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.